Marketing Your Private Practice is a podcast where you'll learn easy to implement tips and strategies to grow your business without spending all day online. I'm your host, Kathy Colaiacovo, and I teach practitioners the Thrive Marketing Method to create simple and streamlined plans by focusing on long-term strategies, not just social media. Discover ways to spend less time on your marketing, attract more clients, and build the financial freedom that comes with a thriving practice. One where you have time left in your day for the people and things that matter to you. Hey, Private Practice Heroes. It's Kathy Colaiacovo with the Marketing Your Private Practice podcast. And today we're doing one of our free marketing reviews. And I have a guest here in the studio with me, Elizabeth Pinkerton, and she owns Pinkerton Coaching. Now, Elizabeth is an ICF certified coach, and she works with entrepreneurs and solopreneurs and likes to blend her real world know-how with her coaching expertise to help support entrepreneurs and solopreneurs on their journey. So, Elizabeth, welcome to the podcast.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right. Well, I am great to have you here. I love doing these free marketing reviews because I feel it gives people some really good insight and some outside perspective on what they're doing with their business or their practice. But before we dive into Elizabeth's review, I want to remind all of you listening in that these reviews are free and open to everyone. They're a way that I can help business owners and practice owners who might be stuck somehow with their marketing and having some sort of roadblock growing their business or their practice, and it's holding you back. So I like to offer these sessions so that you can get some of that outside advice and get some insight on what might be going on so that you can move forward and start seeing results that you're looking for. And for a lot of people, that also means not wasting time on marketing that is going nowhere, helping you reach your goals. So, Elizabeth, let's get started into this. So you booked one of their free reviews. I usually ask people to give me a topic, whatever that they wanted to focus on. So you wanted to focus on your website. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to read back exactly what you said in the application. So you said, "While I've been able to get traffic to my website from LinkedIn posts and ads, I don't get conversions. I've offered free sessions and events, but I'm not getting any traction." And for those listening in, if you want to check out Elizabeth's website, it's pinkertoncoaching.com. So with this, Elizabeth, as we start this off, there's usually a couple questions I like to ask people when it comes to why you wanted the review and kind of what the roadblock is. So when you're saying that you're not getting traction, you're not getting conversions, can you tell me a little bit more about what you feel is happening or what you're experiencing?
Sure. So I have done some posts on LinkedIn, even experimented with some LinkedIn ads or Facebook ads around promoting a particular event or offering what I call a free discovery sessions. And I can see people are coming to the site. Not a ton because I've just been doing little tests. I didn't want to spend a great deal of money yet. But I'm not getting people to take any action once they're on my site, either signing up for a session or event or even signing up for a newsletter.
Okay, perfect. Okay. So we're going to back up a little bit now that I have an idea of what the problem is. So I did a little intro of you, and I typically source my bios or intros from people's websites, because I feel it's a good way for you to hear somebody who didn't know you because we've never met before to get an idea of what they think you do and offer from what they found on your website, which is what I did. So from what I said and sort of giving me a little more background here, can you tell me if the bio I gave was kind of missing anything about what you offer? And give us a little more details on what kind of services that you do offer your clients. So you have coaching services, but I want to know a little bit more about them.
Sure. So I thought your intro was correct in terms of how you described it. But I try to work with entrepreneurs and solopreneurs who've already been in business for some period of time. So maybe they have been in business for a couple of years, and they're at a point where they're stuck in some way. Either they're facing a decision they need to make about the next step in their business, or they're encountering some challenge they are not quite sure how to navigate and looking for support and guidance on that, or they're just looking to grow their capabilities. And so those are the areas I try to focus on.
Okay, perfect. And then give me a little bit more information about your services, your coaching services. So
sure.
What do you offer? Do you have just one-offs? Do you have, you know, people can work with you for a set amount of time? Give us a little overview of that.
Yeah. Too. Yeah. So I generally engage with people for, say, a 3-month period. That's most typical. And doing sessions every other week is the most common model.
Okay. And when you work with them for these coaching services that you have, what end goal are they typically looking for? Like, I know you talked about, you know, they have some problems, they have some issues, they're not getting traction, you know, things like that. You help them move forward. But do they have specific problems that they talk about that they're looking to solve?
That's a good question. It really depends. And this is where, and maybe this is where I'm not very clear and could use some guidance on, but sometimes it's very concrete. So it may be things like struggling with how do I make sense of my financials and how do I, you know, maybe I'm intimidated by the financial side of the business and need help moving forward with that. Or it could be I'm, you know, growing my team and I don't know how to support and develop my team. Okay. Or it could be their own mental blocks. Like I'm really stuck. I'm tired. I'm overwhelmed and I've fallen out of love with my business and I'm not quite sure how to move forward.
Okay. And that's a really good sentence, by the way. I've fallen out of love with my business and I don't know how to move forward. You need to save that for some marketing.
Okay.
So, because what you just said, you really clarified for me a little more about your clients and their problems, which I didn't actually find on your website when I took a peek before we talked here. And I haven't done an in-depth look at it. You know, I'm just kind of looking for a quick glance. And I always say that's a really good test because when people come to your website, you have about 10 seconds or less to capture their attention. Yeah. So if someone like me taking a quick peek can figure out what you're doing, you know, who you help, how you help them and what you do with them and kind of that big problem you help them with, that's a good sign. Mm-hmm. I didn't find that there. Like it was very generic in some of the wording that you said. What you've said here just now, and by the way, you will get like all of my guests on these free marketing reviews, you're going to get a transcript of the podcast of this recording. So you'll be able to go back and look at those exact words that you said. But some of those phrases that you said did hit home a lot better than anything that I saw on your website. Mm-hmm. And that's the biggest thing that a lot of people struggle with websites and marketing and growing a business, is making sure that you've got the right words on your website and the right messaging so that people understand and fully understand when they come to that website and, you know, they clicked your LinkedIn post or that ad that you had and went to your website, that they fully understand, you know, what you offer, who you help, how you help them, that you get their problem. That's a big thing. People want to know that you understand the problem they're having and that you have a solution. So when you talk in messages and words and content like that on your website, that's the kind of thing that can hit home better. Now, on your website, and I'm gonna be peeking at it here as I talk to you. So when I go to your website, which for those, again, as I said, those listening in, it's pinkertoncoaching.com. So the big headline on there, so you do have a bar, like a sticky bar up at the top that says, join me for on April 24th for 5 mistakes entrepreneurs and solopreneurs make and how to avoid them. So you've got like a highlight of this event that you have. But without that there, so if we pretend that's not there and this is your normal when you don't have that event, the first thing that I see at the top, and I do love the picture of, you know, sneakers and a yellow, you know, yellow tape on the line and kind of being stuck there. It says, what's your next step? Entrepreneurship is a journey, yet the path forward isn't always clear. A coach can help bring clarity by serving as your thought partner, navigator, and co-pilot. Find out more. So when you look at that, like what's your next step? That's actually something people are probably thinking when they come there. And yes, that they're wondering about it. But the stuff that you just said to me about your ideal client, you know, they're usually 3 to 5 years in business. They're trying to move forward. They're stuck on the growth. They don't know what to do. They've fallen out of love with their business. some of those words need to get in here more so on your page. And then you kind of, it jumps down to welcome to Pinkerton Coaching. And then a little bit as coach to entrepreneurs, I provide blah, 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 a few details kind of thing and schedule a discovery session. So when you look at this, you're not painting really much of a picture for people of the understanding of what you can do for them. And in everything that you've told me about your ideal client so far, I'm going to ask you, what are they looking for? Yes, you've got their problem. You know, they're stuck. They've fallen out of love with their business. But what are they trying to do? Like, what's their end goal? Do you have any thoughts as to that?
Yeah.
And I know it can be different for a lot of people. And this is where most business owners struggle. It's like, well, they all have different goals and they all have different things in the end. But can you narrow it down to a general idea of some of it? Or even think about that very specific person who has fallen out of love with the business. What are they looking to do in the long run?
Yeah. So I feel like there's this inflection point where they either have to grow, which means, say, adding staff, adding more stress and more pressure onto themselves, while also releasing control to people. And so that's one path, right, is the growth. And that can be really scary for people who are used to controlling everything. And then there's the other path, which is I'm going to just stay small, but that means, you know, that has its own pluses or minuses. Or it could be I'm ready to maybe exit my business and I need to think about how I want to go about doing that.
Okay, so let's go back to the first one we were talking about. The one who wants to grow might need to hire team members. What are they looking for when they're in that spot and they need someone to help them? So if they're deciding that they want to grow, that they're probably thinking about a team, but they don't know how to go about it, why are they looking to grow?
Why are they looking to grow? Well, either they are, you know, they want to satisfy more customers, they want to make more money, they want to achieve, you know, some personal goal they have of having a certain level of size of business.
Okay. And so, and that's where we always get back to. It's always time or money, no matter what we look at here. It is. But for some people, it's very different. So when you look at that person, you know, who's fallen out of love with their business, part of it is they are overwhelmed, they're stressed, they're probably full, they don't know where to go. Do they scale back and limit themselves to a certain amount of income? Are they looking to grow more, which means hiring the team and going through all of that? So they're really at a crossroads, and like what's your next step is where you help them. Mm-hmm. But if at the top of your website, you got back more into the, you know, are you an entrepreneur or a solopreneur? You know, you've been in business for a few years and you just feel some days like you've fallen out of love with your business and you're not sure what your next step is. Working with someone like me, we can nail down what is your drive, what is, you know, the vision that you see and which path should you take and what will be your next step to get you there. That kind of message will probably hit home a little more with people than the very beginning one that you have here, which is what's your next step? Because you're almost like throwing them more confusion at that point versus giving them the help. The idea behind this, I love it. The idea I think that you probably did with the visuals that you have here and the wording is that I'm going to help you figure out your next step. You know, you don't have to stress about it because I'm going to come in there and I'm going to help you figure it out. We do that through my coaching services. We work together and we do the very things that you said. You get personalized support, you'll get some clarity and direction, and we'll give you some action-oriented solutions so that you know what your next step is. Because I feel like what you described to me is these folks are confused about what that next step is.
Yes.
And they don't know, should I downsize? Should I stop with me? Should I grow to more? You know, are there other options? Am I done and I just want to plan for selling the business when it's all over?
Yeah.
So you're helping them figure out that next step. But the way you've got the wording here, I feel like you're probably just confusing them a little more. If they clicked on a LinkedIn post that you had and they come here, they're probably looking for the next step. And you're a little vague on what you're offering them.
Okay. Now on that top part, the first bar, would you say just change the wording, but also make it more content there, or how would you advise?
You don't necessarily need more content up at the top, like a good eye-catching headline so that they keep going, which is where sometimes you'll catch them with some of those questions. Mm. You know, those, are you feeling blah, 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 blah. You know, there's a way to move forward and figure out your next steps without you being overwhelmed, struggling at it all by yourself. So at the beginning, what you typically are looking for, and you'll probably have to look up if somebody else has this, but I do really love what you said. You know, it's like, have you fallen out of love with your business and you're just not sure which path you need to take mm-hmm. at this point? You know, if somebody's feeling like that, that's probably going to catch them more than what's your next step. And you can take them down to that as you go through there.
Okay.
So for me, a lot of what I found on your website is very generic versus specific wording about the kind of problems the ideal client might be having and how you can help them. Okay. So I think narrowing that down a lot more, this is part of what I work on with students in my Thrive Marketing Academy, is we have a whole module on knowing your client, which everybody, you know, it's something that you have to know. I mean, I remember, man, I think I was in 1989 or 90 working at a bank in Canada. And we had this big campaign, Know Your Client, KYC, Know Your Client. And I always think of that, even to this day, like 35 years or so later. But it is important. You have to know your client. And that's why we work on that. And you really have to know and understand what are their problems and what solutions do you offer to help them get to that dream place they're looking for. So your messaging has to speak very specifically to their problem so that they really understand. You get it. You totally understand. And that's often what makes you stand out more from other coaches out there. Because there's a lot of coaches out there in the world that do what you have, that have your experience. So there's always that piece too that you want to think about is, how is what I offer unique and different? So you always have to look at pulling that out, right? So that's a piece of it as well. So I think if you were to do a little more research on your clients, really think about it. You've got some testimonials on your website. Let me just take a peek at some of these. Like often you can find really good information to use in your marketing from the words of your clients in your testimonials. And that was actually recently I did a couple episodes on using testimonials in marketing. Because people will say these words. It's not you creating words. So when you look at this, you know, a career in art is difficult to navigate. You know, she kept me on track. When you look at, you know, I'm just trying to skim through some of these, you know, I feel confident about the path I've chosen. So that's that very thing we just talked about. They didn't know what path. I'm assuming that whoever this was on this testimonial, they probably had no idea what path they should take, that next step. And so your work with them helped them determine probably, you know, what are these problem areas? What are you looking at? What is your vision for where you want to be? And then you help them figure out what path they should take, right? And now they have, you know, it says right here, where am I looking at the path to take? My life's now more connected, fun, and energized, right? So if that was a person who was, you know, fallen out of love with their business, now it sounds like they're probably back in love with their business and life and everything else because of what you did. So if your marketing, especially on a homepage, can really speak to that, then that message will carry out, but you've got to carry it out as well. Okay. So that would be what I would say your number one block is here, is that it's just really not clear on your website some of the things that people can get by working with you. And you do have a Wix website. So I run into a lot of clients with Wix, Squarespace, and typically WordPress websites. Those are the trifecta of ones that I run into people having. Wix has some limitations compared to WordPress, so does Squarespace. But for a DIY website that if you're the person managing it, it is important for you to be able to have something simple and easy to use. And that's why they have sites like this. A couple things that you do want to fix up. So you've got a few technical issues that are happening here.
Okay.
Some of it is your wording. Schedule your free discovery session. Like, be a little more specific. What are you going to get with a discovery session? What am I going to get when I book that with you? Booking a discovery session can be really stressful for people. They're like, oh, I don't want to talk to them. They're going to try to sell me, you know?
Yeah.
So if you can come up with some wording to make that a little less vague and but more specific as to what you're going to do, I always tell people, book a quick chat with me. We'll get on the phone. We'll talk about what some of your issues are. I'll find out what your business is about. And if I have services that I can help you and that will make a fit that we could work together, you know, we'll do that. So it makes it feel a little less stressful when you say that versus just sort of that generic schedule a free discovery session. And I'm a big believer in wherever you put a button like that, you need to make the words on that button, those action words, the CTA on that button, fit whatever they were looking at before. Okay. So for instance, on your homepage, you have, you know, as a coach, I do this and I do to, you know, we offer these kinds of things, blah, 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 blah. And then you have a button and it says, schedule your free discovery session. You'll probably get more people clicking the button if you say, you know, if, and you're going to have to rework kind of the homepage anyhow and reframe the whole thing. But if you took them on a different path and you talked about how you helped them figure out the next step, you know, if you're looking to find out, you know, where you should go in deciding that next step of where you need to be, click here, let's book a quick call, talk about that and see how I can help you, you know, make those choices and move forward. That's a lot more specific than just your schedule, you know, book a free call, book a free session. That's what a lot of people just sort of leave on the website. Okay. Yeah. The other tip I have for you is you're actually hiding yourself a little bit on your website. And I know you're going to say, Kathy, what are you talking about? Because on my homepage, I have my picture, I have my name, I have a learn more about me, and all of that. I don't know if you realize this, but on your about page, you actually, I'm going to double check here. I'm going to hit a button and do something. The only time on your about page that your name is written is in a testimonial at the bottom of the page. And your last name is not there. It's just your first name.
Wow, interesting. Okay.
Okay. And your button again on that page, it's great you've got a call to action at the bottom, but it also says schedule your free discovery session. Right?
Yeah.
And you're just being, again, very, you know, even across the board and just keeping it simple. You're a certified ICF coach. I think you can get buttons from them to highlight on there. You could put on your website page too.
Okay.
But for me, the biggest thing is literally going through your homepage, your coaching programs page. I'm going to double check here because I want to make sure I'm saying the right thing. And of course, by the time people go to look at this, she'll have changed it by then. But the phrase Elizabeth Pinkerton is not on your website in any spot together. The two words together.
Interesting. Okay.
Okay. And it's something a lot of people do. You have Welcome to Pinkerton Coaching. You have I Am Elizabeth. Those are on the homepage. And then on your about page, you're like, hello, my approach, my story, you know, all of this. But you don't have your name. You don't have your title. Okay. Those are key words for any business owner. Your name, your title, your company name, even your location. So you're missing out on a lot of keyword-rich content. But for me, the biggest thing you're missing out on here is actually telling people who you are. Because if they want to hire you, I think they would like to know your first name and your last name. And pointedly have it there versus just, I mean, everybody's going to assume Pinkerton Coaching, you know, and Elizabeth. It's probably Elizabeth Pinkerton. But you're actually not telling them your name. And this is a really common thing I find on about pages. It's like people want to hide who they are. Mm-hmm. You shouldn't be hiding it. You should be putting it right out there because it is your on, you know, we talk as a website is an online business card. And that's great. But when you think about any business card always has your name, a lot of people put their title, how you reach out to me, you know, how you get started. So that's the kind of things that you want to have on here as well. And don't think you're alone in this, because I'll tell you, when I do website reviews or audits, it's one of the bonuses everyone in my academy gets is they get a website and SEO and blog review from me. And I will tell you, I should be keeping track, but I will bet that about 60 to 70% of the websites I review on the about page do not have the name of the business owner. Which if you're a company, a big company, and you know, have lots of team members, that might make sense because your brand is more the company. But Pinkerton Coaching is Elizabeth Pinkerton. So you need to be there. You need to be letting people know more about who you are. Okay. So I feel like that's a lot of your problem because you're doing a good job. You've got links and you're sending people to your website and you've got the information there, but you're just, that's a big foundation. The website is huge. It's the base of all your marketing foundations, but you're missing a lot of key elements. For instance, the other thing that I'm always looking for is social proof. So typically your testimonials are part of that. Great. But are you a real person? And of course, right now, I don't even know what your real name is, but right. If you had a link on the bottom of your website in the footer to your LinkedIn profile, I could actually learn a little more about you there. Or to you, you have an Instagram profile as well. If you're using it for business, link it over there. And then those will always have links back to your website. And those back and forth links are great. It's part of your digital footprint online. So it's key to have them connected. So those are a couple of the things that I would tell you right at the beginning. I think part of your problem is you're sending people over to the website, but it's just not quite clear to them who you are, who you help, and how you help them. And a really inviting way to get started, right? I've talked recently on some of the podcasts I've done about core website pages and different things on you know, how to make it work well. And one of the ideal things you always want to have on your homepage is make it easy for people to understand exactly how to get started with you. So booking a discovery call is great, but you can also do things like, you know, how do you get started and make all of this happen that I've told you about? Mm-hmm. You know, one, book a call, let's talk. Two, we'll put into place, you know, review everything you need, customize, get it, you know, talk about that personalized aspect that you do with them, with the support. And three, you know, on my website, I say you, that's where you get out and you thrive and you, you know, become the practice owner that you're looking to be, or the business owner. In your case, you help them get past and decide what is their next step, so that they can move on to achieving that goal of whatever it is. So making things really simple like that for them, I think you'll turn things around if you change some of your messaging like that.
And for that 1, 2, 3 piece, would you put that on the homepage, or would that be kind of a link in the coaching?
No, I would put it on the homepage. Now for me, I will put links to those episodes. I did 2 episodes on website pages that share a bit more information. So for instance, every page on your website should have a call to action of some sort, but it needs to fit the content. Like kind of the same way I said your button to book a call, make it flow from there. You know, on your about page, you've got a button that says, let's chat, right? Yeah. So you want to be more pointed than that. Like you talk about helping people, you know, and supporting them with coaching expertise. Again, I want you to change that a little bit, because a lot of what I'm finding on your website in particular is more about you than about the client that you're going to help. Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
And it's hard to turn that around. I mean, I find stuff of mine all the time and I'm like, I focused, not we, right? Not them.
Yeah.
And so it is a challenge to do that, but that kind of easy thing to get started, if you have a good flow on your homepage, you know, partway down, you'll have that, you've got them at the place, like, are you ready to do this? It's very simple to get started. 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Yeah, makes sense.
So, I mean, there are definitely lots of other things that I could give you tips on and advice on in here as well. We don't really have a lot of time to do that, but this should get you started, because this is the main issue that I see that you're having, is the message you're putting out there isn't hitting home, which is why if somebody comes there, they're kind of backing off and not clicking any buttons.
That makes a lot of sense. I did try to mine some of the testimonials, and that's where I got like the navigating the journey. And I tried to pull some of those phrases in, but I completely get what you're saying about needing to be more specific.
Yeah, well, and I really want you to go back to the transcript that I'll send you from this, and you'll be able to listen to the recording too. When I asked you at the beginning about your ideal client and some of the problems that they were having, you were so specific. But on the website, you really are not. And that's the big thing that I would be telling you to change. You know, when I look at your homepage, and again, I'm not picking on you, but it's what's there, right? Mm-hmm. Entrepreneurship is a journey. The path forward isn't clear. A coach will help you bring clarity and serve as your partner, navigator, and co-pilot. it's there. It kind of gives you something, but it doesn't hit home with people. And again, you've got the big question there. What's your next step? And I'm like, I don't know what it is. Like, help me figure it out. So I feel that would do better once you go down and you kind of paint a different picture first, right?
Okay.
And we talk about in part of the training that I do, you know, a lot of people will talk about, you know, you lead with your benefits more than the features. And that's still hard to do for anybody. You know, we have a couple SEO issues here. Like you've got big words in an H tag on there. Welcome to Pinkerton Coaching. That's not keywords for you. Pinkerton Coaching is, but people are only going to type that in online when they know of you. Welcome is not a keyword for you, but you're trying to make it welcoming by put this big word there, but it's in a really keyword rich spot for the search engine. So you're kind of wasting time. You know, that could do better with business and entrepreneur coaching or something like that. Those are better words for you. But you talk about what you provide, personalized support, clarity and direction, action-oriented solutions. Whereas what you want to get into there is, you know, I mean, I really like the fallen out of love with your business thing. You know, you're too busy to figure out how you can scale and add a team. You're, you know, if you get into some of that, they'll be sitting there reading going, oh man, yeah, that's me. That's me. Okay. What do I do to get this help? Yeah. I don't know what my next step is. She can help me do it. And I know who she is because her name's Elizabeth Pinkerton. Okay. So you want to have that all in there so that people will really see and know exactly what it is you offer. So getting to there, then when you get into, you know, putting, sending people over to register for the free session that you have to book, you know, to learn more, to talk about, you know, get on the newsletter list, all of that's going to make a little more sense. And you're probably going to see more people then clicking and booking some calls or doing some other action of some sort, because it's just a little more clear what you could be offering me when I visit. That makes sense?
It does. Yes, very much so. Thank you.
Okay. Awesome. Awesome. So any other final questions that you might have before as we look at this? I know it's hard in the moment here. You're sitting there going, all this ton of information that she said and, you know, what do you do now? But anything big standing out that you're not sure on?
This might be a silly or a minor thing, but on the menu bar at the top.
Yeah.
The ordering of that. I'm just curious if there's any thought around like what would be the ideal order and if my order is
good. Okay. So you've got home, coaching, programs, events, testimonials about, and then up in the top right, you've got get in touch. I always like to look at, and I don't know if this is a specialty thing or not, the first one is always the home typically. The ending one is kind of your more important one. A lot of people have contact there because ultimately you want people to contact you in one way or another. So you've got your get in touch there, which is up and very visible. I would probably be like most people, if they're coming to the homepage, they want to figure out who you are. You know, a lot of folks will have the about as the second one in there. And you have a small amount of menu items. So for now, testimonials having its own tab is great. Some people will put it under the about, but right now, you know, you're trying to get the word out. So having it up there showing, and I do believe in having a page because I think it's important to have a spot where people can go. They're going to go look to see, okay, who's worked with her? What did they say? Right?
Yeah.
Your events is in there and that one is good as well. And your coaching programs. I mean, you've got them up there. They make sense. When people get really clever with these, sometimes it can be a challenge to understand what you're going for, but yours make total sense. I just probably would put about after home. Okay. Events is probably, and that's a free event, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So I would probably call it free event and put it at the end. So it stands out a little bit more. Yeah.
Okay.
I would probably look at doing it that way. Okay. And I'm going to give you a quickie tip. So this is my bonus tip for you. I always end up giving somebody a bonus tip on these reviews. Your event, 5 mistakes entrepreneurs and solopreneurs make and how to avoid them. What do you think's missing from in there?
Oh, goodness. I have the D to me call to action. I mean, I have join me, but I don't have
a button. Why do I want to know about the mistakes, right?
Okay.
So there's mistakes we make and how to avoid them, but what do these mistakes cost me?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you kind of reworded that title of that event, you may find yourself with more people understanding why they should sign up and RSVP for it.
Okay.
And in the about the event, like you do say some of it, you know, making mistakes is normal. You can learn from the mistakes of others and avoid them for yourself. But again, you're telling me you want me to avoid the mistakes.
Why?
But why?
Okay.
It's sort of the same thing as, you know, why do you, you know, offer these services? What am I looking for as the client here? You really need to throw that into that webinar as well. Because right now it's like, learn about the mistakes. Okay. But it's not going to drive them. Mm-hmm. It doesn't give them any curiosity as to what they could be avoiding.
Okay.
Yeah. So I would get a little more specific with that. So I think if we had to pick an overall theme here, specificity is what you need.
I'm getting that loud and clear.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Okay. So Elizabeth, before we finish off, how can people connect with you and find you online? Do you want to share where they can find your website? I know we talked about your website. Your social's a little hidden, but let us know on social media where you're at too.
Sure. So my website, of course, it's pinkertoncoaching.com. And I'm also on LinkedIn. And you can find me under Pinkerton Coaching or under Elizabeth Pinkerton.
All right. Perfect. Okay. And I will put links to those in the show notes. Wherever you're listening to this podcast, I'll have some links to Elizabeth's information so you can connect with her if you want to. And really, I want to say thank you again. I know we were talking before this and you said you'd found me online on the Google and had been listening to the podcast and thought the idea of doing one of these reviews would be cool, but you were a little worried about, you know, getting online and you had never been on a podcast before. And it wasn't so hard, was it?
No, it wasn't. No. You made it very easy. No.
Awesome. I like to do that. That's my whole goal, is making marketing easy and, you know, showing up and sharing some of your troubles, because it's not always something business owners want to do, is share their struggles in what they're doing. But I know a lot of people will learn and get this from that. You know, they'll get lessons from what I talked about with you that they can put it back into their business. So that's why I like to offer these free marketing reviews. And remember, you can always, those listening in, sign up for yours anytime. And I'll have a link to that in the show notes too. So that's it for today. And this is Kathy C. saying thanks for tuning in. Thanks, Elizabeth Pinkerton, for coming in and sharing your information with us. And remember, to thrive in practice or business means getting really clear on your ideal client, the problems they have, and being very specific with the content and the messaging you have on your website, so they totally understand how you can help them and are ready to click those buttons and sign up, a lot more easy than if they're confused and not sure of that next step. So I'll see you folks next time. You can find all of our show notes and resources mentioned at marketingyourprivatepractice.com. Be sure to connect with me on Instagram at pepperitmarketing and say hi. I'd love to hear any feedback you have, and make sure to rate and review the podcast and hit subscribe on your favorite player so you don't miss any future episodes.